In this video, we are going to outline the pros and cons of PCR cloning. Much like PCR itself, cloning of a PCR product is a fast, versatile, and robust process. The cloning methodology is well worked out, so as long as you have reasonably optimized PCR reactions, you can go from PCR product to colonies on a plate in 24 hours. Likewise, the cons reflect the intrinsic limitation of PCR that many PCR polymerases are error-prone. The first pros related to PCR cloning are a reflection of PCR itself. Polymerase chain reaction is a fast, robust, and versatile technology. You can amplify large amounts of specific PCR product from very small quantities of template in a very short time. With easy access to complete genome sequences, acquisition of a genomic clone to develop into a series of molecular reagents has been replaced by PCR. Cloning the PCR product allows you to generate a sequence-verified clone. All the polymerases used in PCR introduce mutations at some rate. When your PCR product is complete, that nice tight band is actually a population of fragments with different numbers of mutations accumulated in them. By cloning the PCR product into a vector and verifying the sequence, you are guaranteeing that your current and future experiments are based on an accurate and identical reagent. Finally, you can rapidly progress from primers and template to PCR product to bacterial clones. Let's say that you set up your PCR reactions at 9 a.m. on Monday morning. You could run the gel, clean up the product, and perform topo cloning by 3 p.m. You would have candidate clones to analyze the next morning. The next advantages have more to do with the cloning process. If you are going to be adding restriction enzyme sites to your primers, you can choose any restriction enzyme sites that improve your outcome. And as a general rule, you should plan on performing directional cloning. If you are doing TA or topo TA cloning, the commercially prepared vectors produce very little to zero background colonies. Finally, thoughtful selection of your cloning vector can frequently save you steps in your overall cloning procedure. Many topo TA cloning vectors are pre-adapted to common experimental objectives, such as fluorescent protein expression and purification. The first potential disadvantage of PCR cloning is the introduction of unintended mutations. Of course, this is exactly why it is necessary to clone the PCR product and identify a clone that has no such unintended mutations. Unmodified TAC polymerase introduces a mutation once every 10,000 bases or so, and this is cumulative. If you are amplifying a 2 kilobase fragment, a mutation will be introduced once every 2.5 cycles. And once a mutation is introduced, it will be perpetuated in succeeding rounds of amplification. If you amplify a 2 kilobase fragment for 30 rounds with basic TAC polymerase, over 90% of your product will carry at least one mutation. TAC polymerase's high mutation rates necessitated the discovery and development of higher fidelity polymerases. While the mutation rates are much lower than that of basic TAC, it is still necessary to clone and sequence verify a PCR product if you plan on using it in a cloning project. This table summarizes the mutation rates of several popular polymerases and the likelihood of obtaining an unmutated PCR product. If your experimental plan includes one of the PCR capture techniques described here, there is a likelihood that you will introduce cloning scars into your construct. Depending on your future plans for your PCR clone, the scars may be transient or otherwise insignificant. If you anticipate that the scars will adversely affect the outcome of your project, you would be advised to explore the more advanced scarless cloning techniques. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.